What is up, everyone? Martina here, and today, as you can see from this spooky background, we have a Halloween. Anyway, I really love paranormal stuff. I really love spooky stories, like all the ghosts, demons, and all sorts of stuff. So pretty much the moment when I moved into Shanghai, I was super curious. Tell me what's going on here. Any ghosts, any haunted places, I want to know. So actually there is quite a few within people who are in Shanghai for quite a while. It's the story about the Paramount. So Paramount is just behind the temple. During the evening, looks amazing. I actually never was able to like fully get in because you have to pay the entrance fee, like not really entrance fee, you have to pay I think around like 500 RMB for going to some tango classes or like any kind of like dance-ish classes. So at the end, I never really managed to get in there. I still have it on my list, so hopefully. Let me tell you then about the story of the Paramount murder. So pretty much Paramount at 30s, it was a place to be all the most rich, most famous, most, you know, well-connected people were coming up there. Paramount was pretty much built in very New Yorkish style, so the locals as well as foreigners were showing up there. And you know, like even Charlie Chaplin with the Pauline Guard, they show up there. They had like one night in China, in Shanghai, and they decided to go there. They were dancing. It's it means something. Come on, Charlie Chaplin, yo. Anyway, dark story happened at 25th of February, 1940. There was a pretty much famous taxi dancer. If you don't know what taxi dancer is, pretty much like, you know, you're renting, you're getting the taxi, just pay for the time. In this one, not kilometers, but for the time. So you can pretty much just like rent a dancer who will dance with you. So there was this dancer, Chenman Lee. She was pretty famous, kind of unfortunate stories to her, even before it was happening before. She was married 3 times. I think she was like widow like twice. So after her second husband had died, she came back again to Paramount to be a taxi dancer. The legend goes that she got shot by the Japanese officer. Why? Because she simply refused to dance with him. He, you know, it was back then the Japanese were occupying Shanghai, so as it was a pretty much famous place, you know, like place to be, maybe right now like Band or I don't know, Bar Rouge. All right, now in Shanghai. So everyone was going there. Obviously, if the city is occupied by Japanese, they want to, you know, taste all the best stuff in all sorts of ways. Anyway, the story goes that the officer, he came up with the other like Japanese military, and once he saw her, she was, you know, he really liked her, so he asked her for a dance, but she refused. Apparently, due to the, you know, like, he got pretty much pissed. He took out the gun, shot her a few times. She died on the spot. And it really became a very famous case, which was showing up in the newspapers. It was, as I mentioned already, it was, you know, like, talked about within Shanghai's people, within Chinese people. It became kind of this, like, very heroic thing, like, you know, the anti-Japanese statement that she had made, that she did not decide to dance with the Japanese officer. But if you would do some digging, it actually comes out that it's not true. So let me tell you what happened. I mean, obviously there were some Japanese officers who might have asked her. She might even refused, but no one killed her. I mean, no one from Japanese officers kill her. So according to the North China Herald, she was in the Paramount ballroom. It was, you know, already the night was coming to an end, I would say. I mean, it was midnight, but I don't know what their normal schedule would be. But yeah, like apparently the band was playing the last waltz, there was some last dances, and she was sitting with two of her friends. They were drinking, I imagine, champagne. Suddenly there was like the guy who ran into it, and he took out a gun and he started to shoot in the direction of their table. So Chen Lee, as well as two of her friends, they got shot. She got shot 4 times. One of her friends, she got shot, I think, somewhere in the arm. The other one, unfortunately, he got shot somewhere around the chest. So what happens there is that she did not die on the spot. She got taken to the hospital, the Red Cross hospital in Shanghai. And the day after, due to her wounds, she had died. But through the time before, when she was still conscious, she actually did mention that she knew, like, she knows who had shot her. She said that it was one of her, I wouldn't have to say, like, one of her fans, one of her secret admirers. I mean, not the secret if she remembered him, but you know what I mean. So apparently he probably got jealous and decided to shoot her. He was like, if I cannot have you, no one can. That sucks, dude, that sucks. But yeah, that's pretty much this, that's the story. So at 26th of February, she genuinely had died. And the unfortunate story became very heroic, kind of act. I think it, you know, it's cool as long as it could have had helped people to you know, like, to stand up and fight for their rights over here, to, you know, get the Japanese out back at the time from the city. And it's actually like this story is like still going through even until now. I think that the version of the story people most know about is the one that she got shot by the Japanese officer rather than by her, like, one of her Chinese admirers. But yet, what the people, when it comes to like more of the you know, haunted things about the ghost-ish things, is that the staff who is working at Paramount is saying that sometimes through the night you can hear in the, like, in the ballroom, you can hear like the slow clicks of the heels. It's kind of like she's dancing by herself at the ballroom, which is kind of sad but also spooky as fuck. I mean, you know, imagine working there, and like the Paramount, obviously during the day it looked an evening, it looks amazing, but once everyone is out and you hear, you know, like some clicks, like someone is dancing, hell no, I will quit, that's for sure. Another story is that at 1990s, they've been doing some renovation with the ballroom, and unfortunately one of the workers who've been helping out with the renovation, he had fall down and he died on the spot. And what is also said after the incident is the workers can still hear some of, like, something falling down, but if they will come up to the barroom or they will like go where the sound came from, they would not see anything that could possibly have fallen down. Spooky. Happy Halloween, everyone. And if you liked it, let me know, because there's so few stories about like the haunted places, scary places that happened here in Shanghai, that are here in Shanghai. So if you're curious, just you know, comment. I might drop you one more video if you would like. So yeah, have a spooky Halloween. Please stay safe, it's still a pandemic, so you know, take care of yourself, and yeah, that's it. Bye.